This is Generation Stadia, giving you that daily dose of everything and anything cloud gaming related, and today we're going to be going over some Stadia news. Today we'll be taking a look at the highlights of the latest This Week on Stadia blog post, and there are certainly things worth talking about. From Stadia hosting a live hangout on YouTube where they'll showcase 4 new trailers for upcoming games and updates to Stadia Games and Entertainment, to 5 new games dropping on Stadia this week, and much more. So let's not hesitate and let's dive right into this, beginning with a new free-to-play entry onto Google Stadia. Well, maybe not new, but it is now fully free-to-play for everyone to access on Google Stadia regardless of whether or not they're a Stadia Pro subscriber. And I'm talking about Super Bomberman R Online. This is actually one of my favorite games on the platform, and I'm extremely happy to see it being fully free to play. And that's for multiple reasons. One, I genuinely like the game, so having more players to play with is just a fantastic bit of news. But two, and more importantly, this is still a Stadia exclusive title, so it's great to have this sort of thing be free. It's an experience that at this point in time can't be played on any other platform, so that is incentive to check Stadia out. Better yet, the game does support click to play, so if you're interested in playing it yourself, be sure to check the description of the video and click on that link. It'll take you right to the game so you can hop right in for some free Bomberman action. Now before we move on to the next highlight, I do want to ask you all to place a bet on what you think will be the next free-to-play title on Stadia. Let me know in the comments section below, I'd look forward to seeing who's actually right. But now let's take a look at the 5 games coming to Google Stadia this week. First up, let's take a look at Immortals Fenyx Rising. This is Ubisoft's brand new franchise, which is an epic open-world action-adventure. You'll be playing as Fenyx on a quest to save the Greek gods from a dark curse. You'll be facing up against many mythological beasts on your journey, and you're gonna have to take them on head first. Now, you will acquire the power of gods throughout your gameplay, and if you haven't already, I would highly recommend you check out the exclusive Stadia demo that's currently available now. It's free for everyone to try, and if you haven't, be sure to do so, as there is an exclusive reward for completing it. The title will be launching on December 3rd, priced at $59.99. Next, let's take a look at Outward. This is a game where you'll challenge a hostile world in a unique survival RPG hybrid. You're going to have to deal with things like weather, hunger, and vicious creatures, and it is a pretty tough game from what I've heard. It should be noted that the game does offer 2-player local multiplayer as well as 2-player online co-op. The game does also constantly autosave, so you will have to live with every decision you make. As a heads up, I will be doing a more in-depth video on this game, so be sure to subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications not to miss out. Outward is now available on Stadia and is priced at $39.99 US. Next up is Chronos Before the Ashes, which is also available today and priced at $29.99. It's described as an atmospheric RPG that chronicles a hero's lifelong quest to save their homeland from a great evil. Now, if I'm not mistaken, I'm pretty sure I played the original experience when it was a virtual reality title. Now, if it happens to be anything similar to that, you can definitely expect a Zelda mixed with Dark Souls-like experience. To be fair, it was a very fun title, and I was actually pretty happy with what I played. I'm very curious to see how it plays in comparison to its VR counterpart. If you are interested in hearing or seeing more about this game, do let me know in the comments section below, as I am currently debating picking it up. Now let's take a look at something just a bit more colorful, and this is Fogs. It's a game where you'll play as a duo of dogs on a captivating puzzle-filled adventure. But this time, you're linked by a stretchy belly. You'll need to bark, bite, and bounce your way through obstacles set across the themed worlds of food, sleep, and play. You can play this game in both local and online co-op, as well as single player. As the description states, it's very much so a puzzle platformer, so if you're into that type of experience, you should consider checking it out. I can see it being a ton of fun and really shining when played with a friend for sure. It's a very, very different title than everything else so far, but it's a very welcome one because of it. Its colorful art style is pleasing to the eyes for sure. Now let's take a look at the fifth title that's coming out this week, and that's El Hijo. I did go pretty in-depth in a video previous to this one, so I won't say too much about it, but what you can expect is a spaghetti western stealth game. You'll be tasked with taking on the role of a 6-year-old boy who goes on a quest to find his mother. I have to admit that I really do enjoy the art style this game is going after, and overall I'm pretty excited to see how it turns out. It being a stealth game that you play from a top-down point of view seems like it could be a very interesting concept. But now let's get into the next bit of news, and it's about Free Play Days coming back, this time featuring the Elder Scrolls Online. From 7 AM Pacific Time on December 3rd to 7 AM on December 9th, you'll be able to play The Elder Scrolls Online free with Stadia Pro. It is important to remember that while this was a Stadia Pro title at some time, there have been plenty of new users who have joined recently. And for them, it's their chance to try out an MMORPG on Google Stadia. And in case you're wondering, yes, the game is cross-play and does offer cross-progression with the PC version. Any and all purchases that you made on PC, be it expansions or anything else, will also transfer over to Stadia. But now let's dive into the last bit of news, which may very well be the most exciting. On December 3rd, starting at 9 AM Pacific Time, you'll be able to hang out with Austin Creed and Katie Wilson over on Stadia's YouTube channel. They will be hosting and playing some games live. Not only that, but we'll get a glimpse at 4 new trailers for upcoming games. They've also promised some updates from Stadia Games and Entertainment and a live Q&A session with one of the developers behind Immortals Fenyx Rising. As you can imagine, many in the community are excited about this, and as am I. A lot of people are pointing out toward the updates from Stadia Games and Entertainment, but let's not forget that showcasing Outcasters would be considered an update. So don't go in this expecting first-party reveals just yet. I'm not trying to say it won't happen, but you should keep your expectations in check for what it could mean. Now, I'm sure there's a ton of speculation going around, so if you have any guesses, be sure to let me know down below. Personally, I'm expecting an update on Outcasters and possibly another deal with a third-party studio for another exclusive title. Once again, that's just pure speculation on my behalf, but I wouldn't be too surprised to see this being the case. Either way, December 3rd seems like it's going to be a pretty busy day, and I really can't wait to see what lies ahead. Now that covers all the news I have for you today. If you enjoyed the video or found it helpful at all, be sure to hit that like button as it really does help the channel out. And if you're wanting more content like it, be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell as well. Today's end of video message is going to be a quick question. Do you plan on picking up any of the games that are releasing this week? If so, which and why? For me, the biggest highlight is Immortals Fenyx Rising. I really enjoyed the Stadia exclusive demo, and I'm excited to see what else the game has to offer. As always, thank you for watching. This has been Generation Stadia, giving you that daily dose of everything and anything cloud gaming related. The Gen S community is over 6,000 strong and growing by the day, and until next time, I'll catch you in the clouds.